going on, guys? Jurassic here today. We're back to Detroit, become human. It's like we are back to Connor. It is 7:51 p.m. So sorry about the cracking in the last couple of videos. Hopefully it's fixed now. Basically, my microphone had an update and it added in some new filters on it, and I didn't realize they automatically get applied. So it was doing a limiter twice, which is why it was peaking, and then it attempted to correct and peak again, which is where the cracking came from. It should be fixed now though, so hopefully if not, I will be sure to fix it before the next video comes out. Alright, so it looks like we are searching for you. She has some sort of connection to Connor. I'm not entirely sure if she's like the creator of him, or if she's just like another sentient living inside his mind.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, I've been expecting you. Would you mind a little walk? That deviant seemed to be an intriguing case. Pity you didn't manage to capture it.
Pragmatic explain, no excuse.
Deviants are completely irrational, which makes it difficult to anticipate their behavior. But I should have been more effective.
Did you manage to learn anything?
Diary, signs in the walls, and the birds.
The walls of the apartment were covered with drawings of labyrinths and other symbols. Like the other deviants, it seemed obsessed with RA9.
What else?
There was a diary.
I found its diary, but it was encrypted. It may take weeks to decipher.
You came very close to capturing that deviant. How is your relationship with the lieutenant developing?
Well, we decided to save Hank, so I think pretty good.
He seemed grateful that I saved his life on the roof. He didn't say anything, but he expressed it in his own way.
We don't have much time. Deviancy continues to spread. It's only a matter of time before the media finds out about it. We need to stop this. Whatever it takes.
I will solve this investigation, Amanda. I won't disappoint you.
A new case just came in. Find Anderson and investigate it.
Well, that's good. Hank is now deemed a friend. I definitely feel like our relationship with him is probably more important than catching the deviants, mainly because they want to sit here and try to prove their worth. And if they can't even do that as a detective robot working with other humans, I don't think that, regardless of if they actually do catch all the deviants, if it would matter.
Lieutenant Anderson!
They would just want Connor decommissioned, or robots like Connor.
Anybody home?
And way inside. I'm not going to be annoying. We're going to break in instead. Much better plan. Alright, so look through the car. Not much to see here. Garage door appears to be closed. No signs of a break-in. Are we really just supposed to keep ringing the bell? I feel like that would sit here and annoy him so much. Then I'm going to do that as like the last case thing. We might be able to hop the fence or possibly around this corner here. There we go. That's what we got to do. Now, what do we do if he's actually been kidnapped or something? We haven't actually done that sort of plan. And at the same time, he might be kind of freaked out that he has an android just coming around snooping through his house. Ooh.
Lieutenant Anderson!
Oh man, don't break the window. Oh, he's gonna be so angry. All right, well, we're committed now.
Easy, Sumo. I'm your friend. See? I know your name. I'm here to save your owner.
All right, let's get him. I'm guessing he just drank too much and passed out, but it's kind of weird to pass out in like the middle of the living room. I think he would have at least made it to the couch. All right, well, obviously there's going to be an alcohol bottle. 40% alcohol content. He had a gun. Is he planning on killing himself? 357 Magnum, one bullet remaining. All right, now that's kind of suspicious. Traces of alcohol. Yeah, we kind of figured that part out. Sight, arrhythmia, no sign of trauma.
Lieutenant.
Back up.
Wake up, Lieutenant. It's me, Connor. I'm going to sober you up for your own safety.
Hey!
I have to warn you.
Leave me alone, you fucking android. Get the fuck out of my house.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but I need you.
All right, get up. We got a job to do.
Thank you in advance for your cooperation.
We get the fuck out of here.
All right, Hank, where's the bathroom at? Are you really trying to get me to eat him?
Attack!
Fuck, I think I'm gonna be sick.
Alright, so we don't want him to get sick on the wall. Hopefully he does this in the restroom so we don't have to see it. Get in there.
Oh, leave me alone, you asshole. I'm not going anywhere.
Are we really gonna have to force him in here?
What the hell are you doing? I don't want a bath. Thank you.
Sorry, Lieutenant.
Is he really about to push him? Ooh. Oh man, he's gonna be angry now.
Oh, turn it off! Turn it off! Ah! What the fuck are you doing here?
A homicide was reported 43 minutes ago. I couldn't find you at Jimmy's bar, so I came to see if you were at home.
Jesus, I must be the only cop in the world that gets assaulted in his own house by his own fucking android. Can't you just leave me alone?
Rational, aggressive solution, pragmatic.
You seem to have personal issues.
I didn't mean
you
that.
Consult a professional who can help you.
Beat it, you hear me? Get the hell out of here.
Ease or leave? I guess leave?
I understand. I sincerely hope you come to terms with your personal situation.
This homicide. What do we know about it?
A man was found dead in a sex club downtown. The report says that an android may be involved.
You know, probably wouldn't do me any harm to get some air. There's some clothes in the bedroom there.
I'll go get them.
I'm kind of regretting that. I wonder if we should have teased him. I just didn't want to sit here and make him angry at us. I mean, we do have the whole relationship updated as friend instead of just an annoying android, so we got that going for us.
Whatever.
Hippy? Stripey or streaky? I feel like hippy doesn't necessarily go with him and his attitude, so it's either stripey or streaky. Streaky looks kind of Hawaiian, so we'll go with this one. Oh, is he throwing up on the toilet? That's disgusting. Oh, we're in here. Is there anything to look around? All right, here you go, buddy. Oh, don't make us watch. Why is he watching him so closely?
Yeah. Wonderful. Just give me 5 minutes, okay?
Sure.
Oh. All right, well, at least we don't have to hear that anymore. Just got trash all over the place. Now, was he doing like a Russian roulette thing, or what's with the one bullet in the gun? I'm wondering. Looks like he had a kid at one point. Anderson Cole, born 9/23/2029, died 10/11/2035. I'm really curious to see if the gun's hot. Question, say nothing. We question that we don't want. Oh, is it already done?
Be a good dog, Sumo. I won't be long.
I didn't realize that I would sit there and end it. I thought we'd still have a chance to look around. I wonder if we could play with the dog. All right, so find a picture of Hank's son. Looks like there was two other options, so I'm guessing one of these had to do with the dog. Let's see, wonder what the stats are for that. Looks like people prefer the hippie Hank, huh? November 6th, 2038. 8:01 p.m. This must be back to Marcus and the medical supplies.
If they catch us, we're dead.
What do we do now?
We need to find the Cyberlife warehouse. That's where they keep the spare parts and the blue blood.
Follow me.
All right, so Jericho is neutral right now. Come on. See here. I'm wondering, like, what is the best plan of attack, though? Is she just going to pick and choose where we're going, or are we supposed to be finding our own way and leading these guys? So it seemed like we were like the leader inside of like the underground area, but now she's taking charge. Hold on. I'll have a run button. And once we get the medical supplies, how are we going to get it back out without being caught?
Watch out.
Now what do we do?
I'll find another way.
See, now the fact that these guys are androids, they have to be fantastic at actually figuring out how to steal things. Because, I mean, they can see every single solution. And hopefully plan a way out of this. I guess that's going for them in their favor. Now, I'm wondering, obviously there's different models of androids in this game, so maybe certain ones are going to be better at processing different like techniques on how to jump and stuff, because it seems like Marcus has the quickest reaction time to where he's actually able to plan ahead and follow through with all of his moves, where everybody else, we seem to have to do them like instantly or else we die.
Marcus, climb up.
Gotcha. Interesting to see, even though the technology has taken over this world, there's still jobs where humans are actually spectating the equipment and stuff. Alright, so hold on. Where are we actually trying to go, though?
The warehouse is up ahead. We're almost there.
So far, everything seems to be working out relatively decent. Now, is Cyberlife going to be notifying Connor that we break into their warehouse? Cyberlife warehouses.
We have everything we're looking for.
First, we have to get rid of that drone.
Leave it to me.
Are you about to jump on the drone? All right, so hold on. See, this is exactly what we were talking about. That seems like a horrible idea. We're just gonna watch this play through and see what happens. Yeah. I figured that one would fail. And we can go... put over? That'd be too high, so we can't do that option. We might be able to start from over here though and jump over this. Climb on to the next one. Over to the left. There we go. Then plant him attack. Be too far. All right, so hold on. Oh, hop around to this other side here. And now we attack it. But I'm kind of wondering, like, do these androids not have any capability of actually hacking into other equipment?
I need to tear you down.
You okay?
Now they're definitely going to be notified.
Good job, Marcus.
Thank you.
Quick, open the other crates and fill your bags. Take as much as you can.
All right, so hold on. Search through the crates. Get past these people. Now, where exactly are we going to be able to hide all this stuff, though? And I like how it's conveniently all outside the building. So, I mean, that's awkward.
You were trespassing on private property. Your presence constitutes a level 2 infraction.
This is not the android you are looking for.
John! Goddamn machine! Where is it this time?
Let's see here. So we could grab it high.
John!
I need your help.
John!
Release, hold, attack.
The drone, now this. Just my luck.
Let's finish up and get out of here.
Is that it? He's just cool. All right. Still don't have enough. I feel like sparing his life is going to help us out in the long run. It seems like a lot of these androids eventually do turn deviant whenever they're next to another deviant. So this might have put us on the path where he's going to be able to let us out of the gate without us having to have like a bigger confrontation at the end. Pick the bigger crate. See, now you're getting greedy and they're going to spot us. All right, so hold on. Lock you. Or another android's gonna pop out and scare us.
Why aren't you like us? Don't you wanna be free?
Free them? Close again.
Thank you.
That's all we can carry. Let's go.
Why are they? I guess Blue is back to normal.
Take me with you.
He's on their side. We can't trust him.
He took a risk for us. We can't just leave him here.
We can't bring them back with us. It's too dangerous.
Sure, why not?
They come with us.
We make an army.
I know where you can find more spare parts.
What do you mean?
The trucks. They're full of bio components. They run on autopilot, but they can be driven manually with a key.
Where is this key?
Down there, in the control station. There are two human guards. We'll have to get the key without being noticed.
This is suicide, Marcus. Our bags are full. We got what we came for. Let's go before they catch us.
This is a truck full of spare parts. There'd be enough for all of us. We can't pass this up.
And if we get killed, our people will have nothing. We can't take that chance. It's too risky.
All right, let's get the key.
Wait here. If I'm not back in 10 minutes, go without me.
Marcus.
I'm coming with you.
No, I'm going alone. It's not worth it for both of us to risk losing our lives.
I mean, I feel like this is the best option for everybody because we're going to need spare parts eventually. The Blue Blood's only going to last so long, and there's a lot of people who are severely hurt. Hold on. There's at least two guards. Oh, whoa. Yeah, it popped up. There we go. Alright, so we found the key. Where are the dogs at, though? I'm trying to figure out. I hope we chose the right room.
Goddamn dogs. What the fuck are they barking at?
Could be the weather. They don't like storms.
Yeah, I was gonna take my kids camping this weekend. So much for that.
Is Mike still in zone 4?
So we can threaten the guards.
Looks like it. And he should be done already.
Better off in here than out patrolling in that.
What other options do we have, though? That's a blackout. There we go. Okay. Nice. Got the screwdriver. Cause a blackout. Sneak over, grab the key. Surely this is going to be the best stealth approach. I feel like if they see a gun, they're just going to immediately call it in. Yeah.
Shit. What's going on?
Lights are still on. Must be the fuse box.
I got a flashlight somewhere. Here it is.
Fuses are over there.
I don't shit. But I don't get paid to fix fuses.
Let's just. Oh man, keep on going. There you go.
We can call maintenance.
Can go. We did it.
Show yourself. We know you're here.
All right, so let's jog back over to our friends, take the vehicle, and get out of here.
Did you get it? Nice.
Is this their truck?
Hurry, get in.
All right, So all we gotta do is drive out of the docks, act like we're one of them, and we should be good. With the blackout, that you surely won't be able to actually see what they're doing yet, so we should be able just to drive on through. Maybe they would see like the key and shoot us knowing that we have the stolen key.
A truckload. We stole a whole truckload.
We got bio components for everybody.
We couldn't have done it without Marcus.
I came to Jericho because here androids are free. Free to live in the dark, hoping that no one finds us. Free to die in silence, waiting for a change that's never gonna come. But I don't want that freedom. And I'm not gonna beg for the right to smile, or love, or stand tall. I don't know about you, but there's something inside me that knows that I am more than what they say. I am alive, and they're not gonna take that from me anymore. Our days of slavery are over. What humans don't wanna hear, we will tell them. What they don't wanna give, we take. We are people. We are alive. We are free. Yeah!
I feel like that had to have been the best outcome possible. All right, so let's see. How many people actually managed to do this, though? 67% of the people who play this game stole the truck. 46% avoided the guards, so that's actually a very rare occurrence, huh? 67% managed to steal the key. Only 33% created a blackout. Let's see. Looks like we were in majority of all the other decisions, though. Nice! November 6th, 2038. 8:17 p.m.
Oh, feels like somebody's playing with a drill inside my skull. You sure this is the place?
It's the address in the report.
Okay, let's get going.
Jesus. Hey guys, that's going to be it for today. If you guys enjoyed, leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.